Hi, and welcome to Tower Movies. Archering is a great sport, and a bow can also make a big difference in a survival situation. For a good working survival bow, like this little ash bow here, need a little experience and you need time to make them. And to make a really good longbow, you need a lot of experience, knowledge, the right tools and the right material. And finally, you might get a bow out of it like this one here. So let's give them a try and then I'll show you my idea how to make a good working survival bow in a very short time. So let's start with this professional recurve bow and carbon arrows. The next one is this classic but professional made longbow. To show you the difference between the bows and compare them, I'm using the same carbon arrows even for the self-made ash bow. You can also be very precise with a bow like this, but the less power makes it quite difficult under windy conditions like we have here in the mountains to get the arrow straight away into the target. To make a strong survival bow in a very short time, I'm using two of those alder sticks with about the same size and the same diameter. So I cleaned them a little bit and now I have to find out where the middle is. As the next step, I flatten the middle a little bit out by both sticks. In one of the sticks I cut two notches. One is for the bowline and the other one to connect both sticks later on. In the other stick I have only one notch on each side. The next step is to tie them together. So I turn the sticks this way that I have on each side the larger and the smaller diameter, which gives me the same tension on each side of the bow. On one side, I tied it up like this, and on the other side, I'm using the bowline. The next step is to connect both sticks with this rope, and it gives me the possibility to adjust the tension and the power of the bow. To test the survival bow, I have made some Hasselwood arrows a few days ago. In a survival situation, you might not always find perfect feathers like this for your arrow, and you won't have the time to build an arrow like this up. So you can also use some little feathers and just tie them on like this. This will be good enough to get your arrow into a rotation and stabilize it. To build this double bow took me about 30 minutes and I have quite a nice result. Of course there's a difference between the modern carbon arrow, which went straight and precise in the center of the target. With the self-made one like this, you are not that precise, so it's recommended to get as close as you can to your target. So I hope you enjoyed my little bow test and you will join Taro Movies the next time again. Thanks for watching. Tschüss, ciao and bye bye.